guns and money.
MSNBC senior legal analyst and
former prosecutor and NBC News legal analyst Susan Filan. What kind of a deal are we talking about?
The deal is pretty much going to try to wrap everything up. It's very cumbersome for everybody involved to think about trying all these cases. Well, addiction isn't a defense. I mean, the judge has already given her 5 shots at rehab. She has already been in prison 3 times. No, addiction is a disease, but it's not a defense. Breaking rocks in a hot sun. I'm on the law in a low one. I think a defense that's going to be raised by Warner Brothers is whether he's mentally competent. And if he's not mentally competent, does he have legal status to sue? If you text and the person that you text turns around and shows it, it's admissible. It comes in. Privacy and the internet in the same sentence don't go together. If you want something private, don't put it on Facebook. Don't go online. Don't email it. Don't put it on the net. And I think it's very, very, very dangerous to set up this kind of precedent that you can have this kind of slick advertising for surgery. What she's looking for is she's looking to advance the law, and she wants Match.com, now that something's happened to her, to change its policies. That's how the law advances. When hotels used to have windows that didn't have locks on them and people fell out, hotels had to put locks on them. So she's raising the theory here, and maybe by testing it like this case is, something's going to change. I don't think it's such a wacky case, Barton. I don't think she's so out of line. The prosecution's now in a fight with the judge as to what's going to be allowed into evidence. Because what's at stake here is exactly what you brought up in the beginning, Joy, their state of mind. Were they free to leave? How come they didn't just leave? Well, are you going to hold them responsible, or are you going to hold him responsible? And that's exactly what's at stake at this trial.
It's an interesting case.